Hello everyone, welcome to our channel Scheme Tutorials Hub. This is another video of our DBMS lecture series. In this video, we will be discussing with you about the closure of an attribute set and equivalence of functional dependencies along with some examples. I have already discussed about the basics of functional dependency in our previous video. If you have not yet watched that video, then please go through that video at first. I have given the link in the description box, or you can also get the video by clicking the I button. So let's start our today's discussion. First of all, let us see what is closure of an attribute set. The set of all those attributes which can be functionally determined from an attribute set is known as a closure of that attribute set. The closure of an attribute set, say X, is denoted by X within curly braces with superscript plus. Now let's look at some examples for better understanding. Look at the example 1. We are given a relation R with attribute set ABCDEFG and a set of functional dependencies from A to B, BC to DE, AG to G. And we have to find the closure of AC. Here, basically, we have to determine all those attributes which can be obtained from the two given attributes A and C. The attributes A and C are given, so these two attributes will by default be present in the closure set. Look at the first functional dependency, that is from A to B. So as we already have the value of A in our closure set, so from A we can determine B, thus B will also be included. Now look at the second functional dependency, that is from BC to DE. You can see in the closure set, we already have B and C, so the two attributes D and E will also get included in the solution set. Now, have a look at all the given functional dependencies. Can we add any more attributes to the closure set of A and C? So no, it is not possible. Any further attribute will not get added. So our final closure set of AC will include A, C, B, D and E. Now let's move on to our example number 2. Here we are given a relation R with the attribute set A, B, C, D, E. And we are given with 4 functional dependencies, that is from A to BC, CD to E, B to D and E to A. And we have to find the closure set of B. As I have already mentioned, since we are finding the closure set of B, so B will by default be included in the solution set. Now look at the third functional dependency, which is from B to D. So as we know the value of B, so we can determine the value of D. So D will also get included in the closure set of B. Next, there is no other functional dependency from which we can determine any other attribute from B and D. So our final closure set of B will include only B and D. Next is example number 3. Here we are given a relation R with attribute set A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. And we have been given a set of functional dependencies and we have to find out the closure set of B, C, D. So I am not going to solve this one. You solve it by yourself and please let me know the solution in the comment section. Next, we will learn the equivalence of functional dependency. Two or more than two sets of functional dependencies or FDs are called equivalence if the right hand side of one set of FD can be determined using the second FD set. Similarly, the right hand side of the second FD set can be determined using the first FD set. Now let's work out an example for this. In our first example, we have been given a relation R with attribute set PQRS, and two sets of functional dependencies X and Y have been given. Under X, we have three functional dependencies, that is from P to Q, Q to R, and R to S. And under Y, we have two functional dependencies, that is from P to QR and R to S. Now we have been given four options, you can see. And from these four options, you have to choose the correct one. Our first step will be to determine the right hand side of the FD set X using the FD set Y. So let's find out the closure set of the left hand side of each of the functional dependencies of X using the functional dependency set Y. We have already learned how to find out the closure set of an attribute. So let's find out the closure set of P. As we are finding out the closure set of P, so P will by default be present. Now look at the first functional dependency of Y from P to QR. So by knowing the value of P, we can get the value of QR. So Q and R will be included in the closure set of P. Next, as we already know the value of R, so from the second functional dependency of Y, you can see from R we can get S. So S will also be included. Next, let's find out the closure set of Q. Look at the functional dependencies under the functional dependency set Y. You can see that from Q, we cannot determine any other attribute. So the closure set of Q will only contain Q. Next, the closure set of R. So R will by default be present in the closure set of R. And from the second functional dependency of Y, we can see that S can be determined from R. So S will also be included. Next, we will compare the closure set of each of PQR, which we have computed using the FD set Y, with the right hand side of each of the functional dependencies of the FD set X. In the FD set X, we can see that there is a functional dependency from P to Q. So let's find out whether Q is present in the closure set of P, which we have computed using the FD set Y. So Q is present. Now let's move on to the next functional dependency of X, that is from Q to R. So again, let's find out whether R is present in the closure set of Q that we have already computed using Y. So in the closure set of Q, R is not present. Let's move on to the next functional dependency, that is from R to S. And in the closure set of R, S is present. Since the closure set of Q does not contain the attribute R, so it is clear that all the attributes which can be obtained from the FD set X cannot be obtained by using the FD set Y. So we can say that X is not a subset of Y. Our next step is to find out whether we can determine the right hand side of the FD set of Y using the FD set X. For that, let us find out the closure of the left hand side of each FD of Y using the FD set X. So let's find out the closure set of P using the FD set X. As we are finding out the closure set of P, so it will include P by default. Now, from the first functional dependency of X, we can see that if we know the value of P, we can determine the value of Q. So Q will also be included in the closure set of P. Now, if we know Q, we can get R, as we can see from the second functional dependency of X. So R will also be included, and according to the third functional dependency, S will also be included. Now let's find out the closure set of R. So R will by default be included in the closure set of R, and from the third functional dependency of X we can see that S can be determined from R, so S will also be included. Next we will compare the closure of each of P and R calculated using the FD set X with the right hand side of the FD set Y. In the functional dependency set Y, we can see that from P we can get QR, and both Q and R are also present in the closure set of P which we calculated using the FD set X. Again we can see that from R we can get S, and this S is also present in the closure set of R which we have already computed using X. Since all the attributes which can be obtained from P and R by using the FD set Y can also be obtained by using the FD set X, so we can say that Y is a subset of X. Previously we obtained that X is not a subset of Y, and now we see that Y is a subset of X. So our correct option will be B, that is Y is a subset of X. Now let's move on to the example number 2. We are given a relation R with attribute set V, W, X, Y and Z, and we are also provided with two functional dependency set F and G, and we are given four options among which we are to choose the correct option. So I am not going to solve this one. You solve this by yourself and let me know the answer in the comment section. So that's all for our today's video. If you have any query, then please let me know in the comment section. If you really liked our video, then don't forget to hit the like button and also share it with your friends. And if you are new to our channel, then please subscribe to our channel and also press the bell icon for getting the latest updates. Thank you.